Thinking about stealing from your dad's wallet. You might want to suck a little tip on Skid Row. Or you might have a $10 tip from your job at Red Robin.
Is it worth
your $10? I'm going to be going over some differences to pass battle passes. Why you should or should not buy it. With the Season 6 Battle Pass, there are a lot of unique things that it's a first for this Battle Pass. Something you can't get or could not have gotten before in the previous Battle Pass. So as you can see, I got my doggo. Pets are a back bling that have the pet in the back, and it has color variations. So as you can see, I got Bonesy over here. He's customizable, unlockable styles. He looks happy. He's brown. He's got that green scarf action going. He's got some old yeller action. That doesn't end up well for him. Camo. He looks like a little motherfucker, right? He's got some Kool-Aid on his back. Ooh, he's evil. Yo, man. Scales, which is a dragon. To be honest, it looks too serious for me. I need something goofy looking. If we go even further into the battle pass, we unlock more color options for Bonesy. Obviously, these are all cosmetic. Even with the back bling itself, it's cosmetic. There's nothing really helping you. If anything, the pets reveal your position. When you open chests, when you kill enemies, when you're reviving players, it barks. I'm not sure if you can only hear it if you're a teammate, or if it's just like a general map thing where if you're close by, you can hear them. Pretty same deal with Season 5 is that this battle pass, you're getting a progressive type skin, two of them actually. You're getting, of course, you have the very first skin, the Calamity skin, which turns you into a slim, thick cowgirl. And then we're going all the way to number 100, which is Dire, which is probably my favorite skin that I've ever seen in Fortnite. Up to this day, I don't give a shit about Skull Trooper. Don't give me about that Red Knight. This, come on, how can you not like this man? Same deal with V-Bucks. Obviously, that's pretty much the same throughout the battle pass. You are getting a lot of V-Bucks. You're earning them through the battle pass. Let's see, you're getting 1500 V-Bucks out of the season if you buy the battle pass. So that's pretty much a $15 value.
What are you doing just sitting there? $40 value? That shit. My shit's $19.95.
So you're kind of getting your money back, sort of. It's like a credit. Another thing with Season 6 is that they're actually including capes as a unlockable item. I realized that capes were kind of skins that you had to purchase, but now they're actually included in the battle pass, because I think I unlocked one already, which was the Fabled Cape. I know it says, where is it? Note, these items are cosmetic only and grants no competitive advantage. And I say, I'm about to show you right now. Using battle pass items, I'm gonna win. Nope. It's obviously proven that with this battle pass, you are strategically confirmed, guaranteed to perform at least 25% better. Woo! Woo! That's what I'm talking about. 25% increased chance of not missing. That's what it's all about. My kill. Okay. Oh God. 25%. That was a glitch in the system. He's gonna regret doing that. Obviously he was gonna regret doing that. As you can see, I'm not even gonna build a barrier because I'm so confident that with the battle pass, you're 50% more likely to not get shot while healing. You basically just give him the rounds. And then suck him, right? This guy right here doesn't stand a chance. Doesn't know what he's doing, see? Surprise, motherfucker. Exactly, right? There's no competition. What are you talking?
You did.